This food blog radio show is brought to you in part by the Cooking Everything Outdoors show, available on iTunes and YouTube. Hello, foodies. This is Gary House with Food Blog Radio, and I have the honor today of sitting down with Lynn Chen of theactorsdiet.com. Lynn, welcome to Food Blog Radio.
Thank you for having me, Gary.
Absolutely. Thank you for being a guest. I really appreciate you taking the time out of what I'm sure is a very, very busy schedule.
Yeah,
you wear a lot of hats.
I do, and it's pilot season right now, which is the craziest time for an actor.
Oh, I can imagine.
Yeah.
So why don't you start out, Lynn, and share a little bit about us outside of your food, not us, about you, outside of your food blog, and kind of let us know about the foodie behind the food blog.
Sure. I mean, my obsession with food has been since I can remember remembering. I've always had a very long and tortured relationship with food since I can remember, having to do a lot with family and feelings. And, you know, when I was young, I, you know, like most people, I just enjoyed food. And being in entertainment since I was 5 years old, I was always also, you know, there was a big focus put on the way that I looked. So I learned that food directly impacted the way you looked at a very young age. And so I was constantly being told about dieting or about eating disorders, that sort of thing. So for me, you know, food and talking about body image are just sort of linked to one another. And that's one of the reasons why I started this blog, was because of my very complicated history with food and my recovery from a very long battle with eating disorders. And now I wear the hat as the ambassador, one of the ambassadors for the National Eating Disorders Association. So I use my blog as a way to celebrate food, but also to talk about how it can be complicated, but also talk about how it cannot be complicated. I mean, food is something that you have to deal with every single day. You know, it's not like if you have a problem with it where you're an alcoholic, you can just stop drinking. You have to eat. So yes. Our relationship with food, I've learned, everyone has a very personal and often very complicated relationship. So this is just my story, and that's what my blog is for.
Well, this is awesome. I, of course, took a little bit of time to go through your blog, and it's very vast.
Yes, it is, because it's every day.
It is. You're prolific. There's no doubt about it.
It is definitely part of my therapy at this point. Sorry if you hear that noise. That's my dog scratching himself.
No problem.
He's next to me. He's part of my blog too. It's every part of my day. And you know, it's not just the food part. It's my dog. It's my husband. It's what I do. It's when I am working on a project. It's, you know, I've met a lot of people in the food blogging world, but also outside of the food blogging world from it. And I just love the opportunities that it gives you. And who doesn't love talking about food? You know, I mean, everyone has something to say. So it's very easy to meet people and be social with people when you're talking about food rather than a project you're working on or, you know, work, that sort of thing.
It's clearly a common denominator.
Yes.
Absolutely. So Lynn, how long have you been a food blogger?
I started in June 2009.
Okay.
And have not stopped since then. So that's how long it's been.
Now, have you been consistently every day, all day long, posting about what you eat since 2009?
Well, the first year, it was me and a good friend of mine, Christy Myers, who's also an actress. And she's actually also a nutritional health counselor. And so for the first year, it was on and off when we felt like it. Then after a year, I took over full time. You know, I feel like blogging is something that either you love or you don't. And that's often my advice to people who have blogged before. You know, just do it, because you don't know if you're going to like it until you do it. And for Christy, you know, for her, she liked it, but it was a chore for her. Whereas for me, I was like, can you get your blog post up so I can get mine? I have so much to say. So, you know, for me, it's not even, I'm never, you know, searching for, and I don't really ever have writer's block or anything. It's just, I always have something to write about. I always have something to say about food, it seems. So it's really not difficult for me. So after that first year, yeah, it's been twice a day, every single day, because it's every single thing that I eat and how much of it I eat. And I eat every day. So there's always a lot to talk about.
Right. And well, and this is your therapy.
Yes.
This helps you keep focus.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. All right. Now, is this your first and only food blog you've done?
This is my only food-focused blog, where that's just purely food. I have actually two other blogs. One is called Thick Dumpling Skin, which may sound like it has a lot to do with food, and it does. But it's actually more for body image and eating disorders amongst the Asian American community. And this is something that I co-founded with Lisa Lee, and so she and I, we take part in it more of a facilitating forum for our community to talk about, yes, food, but also about body image mostly, and feeling good about yourself in the skin that you're in, mm-hmm. and a thicker skin.
Yes. Quite often. Well, yeah. Lynn, you label yourself as an activist, and I'm sure it has to do with what you just referred to, the body image and feeling good about yourself. And perhaps you can talk a little bit about some of the things that you're doing as an activist to bring all this to light.
Yeah. I mean, I think every day that I post something that shows that actors don't need to be on a specific diet is me being an activist, because for so many years, I believed, as I think most people believe, that to work in this business, you have to look a certain way and you have to eat a certain way. And the truth is, you know, I've been doing this for 4 years now, and I've been analyzing, or not even analyzing, but noticing what other people eat and what I eat and what works for me and what doesn't. Most actors aren't actually on crazy diets. I mean, it's not what the magazines tell you. And what you do hear about when people do get a soundbite from an actor or somebody in entertainment about what foods they're enjoying, you know, that's all it is. It's a soundbite. It's not their life. So for me, showing every single thing from a simple apple, which on most food blogs is really boring, and you know, a lot of people say, like, I don't want to see the apple you ate for a snack. It's important to show, because, as you know, I've gotten a lot of opportunities to eat amazing meals and participate in amazing food conferences and events because of my blog, where you will be eating so much food and so much decadent, lovely food. And I just have to show people that that's just not the way it is every single day. When you watch any sort of food show, and actually I have, you know, the Food Network on pause right now, because it's like stream on, you know, like, that's what I do for entertainment, and it's what a lot of people do for entertainment.
Absolutely.
People know that people who are in the food industry don't eat this way every second of the day. You know, and I think that's important to show. And it's also important for people to see that sometimes when you're around food all the time, it loses its forbidden nature.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot of people will look through my cupboards and be like, well, I couldn't have 6 jars of gourmet peanut butter because I would eat it all. Mm-hmm. And I understand that. Believe me, I used to not be able to have, like, hummus and carrots in the house, because I would just, like, binge eat on them. But once you demystify the feeling that food has to be forbidden, or that there's good foods and bad foods and junk foods and healthy foods, and just look at food as food, and a diet not as something you have to be on, but more of a way of eating, and which changes daily, then food stops feeling so evil, or, you know, or the opposite, you know, like I definitely believe that food has a lot of power, and we can take that power away and make it into whatever we want it to be. And so that's why I consider myself an activist, because I don't think most people are talking about these things in the food world, in the eating disorder world, in the acting world.
Well, I certainly appreciate your activism in these areas. I think that is just fantastic. The question I have is that when you started this blog, your target, was it the average, you know, human being out there, or was it focused on supporting and helping actors? I mean, where were you going with this?
It actually came about because I was reading so many food blogs. I had been a binge eater for so long, and I didn't really know how to portion out my food, or, you know, figure out how to what a serving size. I knew what a serving size looked like, but I couldn't figure out on a day-to-day basis what most people ate. So I started reading other people's food blogs that were daily food journals, and getting ideas for recipes and whatnot through that. And I honestly was doing it just because I needed a way to channel my obsession into a healthy way. And I thought that that might be an interesting way to do it. And once I started doing it, I realized it was holding me accountable, in that I couldn't overeat and I couldn't undereat, because everyone sort of knew what was happening. So that's the main main reason I did it was for me, as something to do, because actors have a lot of downtime. A lot of downtime. I mean, quite often we're spending more time hustling for a job than we are actually on a set. So it's a way to fill your time in a creative way without waiting for the phone to ring, basically.
Okay. Well, you've brought up acting a few times now, and of course the website is The Actor's Diet. Can you take a couple of minutes and touch upon some of the projects that you've done as an actor?
Sure. I've been performing since I was very, very young. My mother was a singer at the Metropolitan Opera House, so I was in the children's chorus growing up. So I grew up at the Metropolitan Opera House, and did acting on and off all through high school with the plays and musicals and whatnot, and took a break in college to become a music and women's studies double major. And then when I graduated, I immediately started acting, which to me meant waitressing. And I quit after just a few weeks of that. I knew it wasn't for me. So I tried other things, and I tried working in schools. I taught HIV education. I tried other things with my life for a few years and realized, no, I really want to be acting. So that's what I did. I saved up enough money and I got an agent in New York. And when I lived in New York, I quite a bit on TV. I did almost all the Law and Order shows. I was on All My Children for quite a while, and I worked commercially a lot. And then in 2005, I did this movie called Saving Face, which went to Toronto and Sundance and Sony Pictures Classics, ended up buying it and distributing it. And so ever since then, that movie sort of put me on the map as the go-to Asian indie film girl. So that's mostly what I've been doing for the last few years, is a lot of movies that, if you're in this community, you probably have seen, but if you're not, you'd be like, what's that? But you can see a lot of these movies on, they're available on Netflix and online, but you probably wouldn't have, you know, you wouldn't go to the theater and see a trailer for it.
Got it. But they could do a Google search and your name and pop up all the movies.
Yes, yes. And on Netflix, even if you did a search for my name, all my movies would come up and you could rent them.
Okay. Well, there you go, everybody. So let's talk a little bit about your style of writing, because everybody has a style. Mine is more avoidance than actual flowing anything. And I write kind of like I talk, which is so okay. What do you feel that your style of writing is?
Narrative.
Narrative. Okay.
I mean, I just sort of narrate what I do.
Okay.
And I let the pictures speak for themselves. I'm so sorry. My mother's calling and I'm going to turn the volume up. The blog is very picture heavy because, as I said, I post twice a day and that can be very time consuming. So to make it less time consuming, it's mostly I let the pictures do the talking and narrate what's going on, and I just basically make commentary. And I can get a post up really quickly because of that.
Actually, I kind of love that style. I do a little bit of that myself, and it does save a lot of trouble. The posts that you do are not just things that you cook, but they're about places you're going and restaurants and events and such also.
Yes, absolutely. And sometimes, you know, it's even like, I've been lucky enough to have a lot of people offer me things for free. So sometimes a fashion designer will, I had a designer design a dress for me. So I did a whole post about that. So sometimes it's just, I'd say it's a more of a, it's a lifestyle blog that is always focused on food. I mean, there's always, I'm always showing what I eat.
Right.
So, and you know, at the very end, it may be all about the dress, but then it'll be like, and I had a handful of almonds. You know,
you have probably one of the finest about pages I've ever seen. You go into detail about what the actor's diet is. And let's touch a little bit about that, because I don't think we specifically address the actor's diet. What do you call the actor's diet?
Yeah, when I started the blog, when I started the blog with Christy, we wanted to explain to the world that actors have to, you know, they have to look a certain, they do have to look a certain way for certain projects, and therefore your diet's going to change because of that. If I'm about to go shoot a love scene, I'm not going to be loading up on burgers. And sometimes, you know, you have to look sick, you have to gain weight. And it was really just an exploration of that. You know, I haven't been doing this a lot lately, but I'd like to do it more. It's just very time consuming. I'm friends with a lot of actors. So I used to make videos of them. Like I interviewed Dave Coulier from Full House and Willie Garson, who's basically in everything. he's like the character actor. And I went to their houses and cooked with them because so many actors are actually quite the foodies. I mean, Willie owns a couple restaurants and is quite good in the kitchen. So I wanted to show that. I wanted to show that actors are not on just one diet. Not everyone here is on Atkins, and although Atkins seems to be a little out of touch these days, whatever the crazy actors are doing these days, you know, I think it's juicing.
A lot of juicing. Okay.
So, press juices seems to be very big. So, you know, sometimes I like be interested in, you know, some of my friends will be doing it and I'll be interested to try it out just to see and give my sense about it. And I think, you know, sometimes these special diets work for certain people. And for other people, they don't. So I just wanted to show that, you know, diets are not one size fit all. So let's explore them together and see what works, what doesn't work, and see what other actors are doing that works for them. Because acting is such a such an interesting career in that, you know, it all your body is your instrument. So you want to make your instrument top notch for certain roles, and for other ones, if you want to feel like crap, you can make yourself feel like crap.
Oh, that's not hard to do, is it?
Yeah. And also, you know, it's what else is interesting is that when you're on a set, you're working these crazy hours and you're surrounded by all types, basically any type of food you want, it's there. And so it's just showing how you navigate those challenges, how I personally navigate those challenges and how other actors would navigate them. Because for so long, it was a struggle for me.
Mm-hmm. Now, Lynn, you have a frequently asked questions page that is quite extensive. What brought about the decision to create that page?
Well, when I first started blogging, I used to, there was a lot more comments going on. And I found that throughout the years, the commenting is less and less frequent. And I think that has a lot to do with the fact that, you know, what are people going to say every single day? But I know that I have a lot of the same readers because they all come out of the woodwork when something, some huge life thing happens or I have a big giveaway. And I'll be like, oh, there's that reader again who's been reading for so long. You know, it's not necessary to comment on every single thing. So a lot of, back in the day, I used to get a lot of similar questions. So I put it in, you know, so I didn't have to constantly tell people the same thing over and over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it is quite, as you said, there's a lot of history going on. And so I didn't want to have to explain, you know, not everyone has read every single post. I would hope they didn't read every single post because it's a lot.
How many posts do you have, Lynn?
Oh, I don't even know because, I mean, I really don't because I've switched servers so many times. So I don't really, to be quite honest, I've stopped quite a while ago. I stopped counting hits and whatnot. I just check like once in a while. It's not what I want to be focused on anymore.
Okay. I think this is something that most food bloggers should really take a look at and do. I don't see it very often. So kudos to you. I think it's quite impressive. One of the things you touched upon here right from the beginning, and I don't know, is this the most popular question you have because it's first? Is what kind of camera do you use? You obviously, it is your most popular question?
I get asked it all the time.
Okay. Yeah. You take all your own photographs and you use small little DSLR, but instant cameras, right? Digital cameras.
Yes, that was a conscious decision. My husband, who works in the industry, also has a gorgeous camera. What is it called? The Canon 4, is it the 3?
3TI?
3D? What was it?
3G? Oh, yeah, 30D, I think.
30D, yes. I don't see. This is all I know. All I know is it's very big and obtrusive. And huge. You're in a restaurant. Although it takes gorgeous photos, it's just very distracting from the experience, I find, for myself, for my fellow diners, and for the people around me. So I like to just take, I mean, I've never said that my site is a food photography site. It's not. But over the years, it's pretty funny how I've learned to just carry on a conversation and snap photos at the same time. And everyone who knows me really well, who's been with me for the last 4 years now, nobody even bats an eye anymore. It's just like me with my camera snapping photos as we're having a conversation.
You have them trained.
Yeah, exactly. Nobody, it's like almost stealth. Nobody notices anymore. And I think that would change if I, you know, whipped out this huge camera and put it up to my face.
I heard recently, or I read recently, where some restaurants are stopping you from taking photos. Did you hear that?
Yeah, I did. I did. David Chang's restaurant, I think, started doing that, which I'm not surprised about.
Interesting. Okay. Now, do you do any photo editing after taking your pictures?
Sometimes I do. Sometimes I have to brighten it up or crop. But that's basically it. I, you know, in the beginning, when I first started food blogging, I, of course, attended conferences, and a lot of them would be about photoshopping and whatnot, but that just, it seemed like, just because of the nature of how I blog, not something that, was for me, because it's so time consuming. It can be so time consuming.
It is.
So I don't really edit. I just use natural light. I put it on the macro setting. I use natural light when I can, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
Because I do vlog at night and often in very dark restaurants and bars. So I do what I can. And if it does need any fixing, all I do is enhance photos in iPhoto, and that's really it.
Yeah. Hello. I love that. Just that auto enhance. That's perfect for me. It's my favorite.
Magic wand.
Yes, indeed. So you have guest stars on your blog also. Mm-hmm. And are these just foodies? Are they actors? Who are your guest bloggers?
I have both. I mean, sometimes they're foodies and bloggers. I've met a number of actors who blog over the years, so it's always exciting to meet them and talk with them and have them do guest posts, which has slowed down a lot in the last few years just because it's very time consuming to put up a guest post, and I don't really need it, to be quite honest. Mm-hmm. I'm always blogging, so you know, I haven't really been doing it as much, but sometimes when I meet a friend and they're a foodie and they're also an actor, I just want to share what's going on with them with the world. So I'll have them do a guest post. And, you know, so it's everyone from actors, and I sometimes have guest bloggers share, you know, some of their favorite things. I have a series called My Favorite Things, and it's just what other food bloggers love. Products that they like to use in the kitchen. Because I think it's fun to share those kinds of tips, and I certainly want to know what my favorite bloggers are doing. I definitely feel like I'm part of a community, and I've definitely met some amazing people through the food blogging community, which would never have happened if, you know, I hadn't started writing about what I eat every single day. So I definitely want to, you know, share as much as I can.
Well, it's a great community. There's no doubt about that. What is your favorite food?
Oh my God, that's so hard. It's like, it's very difficult. You know, I will say this. I was thinking about this the other day. Anything that has the word, the following words in it, I will order. Fig, honey, and date.
Wow.
And chicken. Obviously, I like sweets.
Yes, you do.
So if there could be some, you know, I'm not quiet, Julius. That's sorry. Sorry, my dog's barking.
It's quite all right.
So let's say I'm not somebody who goes to a restaurant and orders donuts quite often. I like donuts, but it's just not, you know, I'd rather have a muffin for the most part. But the big donut, I got to try it, you know. It's just really interesting to me. Or if there's, you know, fig on some sort of, like, I don't order pork very often, but if there's a fig pork loin, it's happening.
It's a goner.
Yeah.
Nice. Where can we find you other than theactorsdiet.com?
I have, my main website is lynnchen.com, which has links to everything. And also, I'm on Twitter under Ms. Lynn Chen. And I have a YouTube page, Lynn Chen Tube. And I am also on Instagram, also under Ms. Lynn Chen. I really love Instagram. I was very slow to the Instagram game, and I was only using it to make fun filters. But then once I saw that it, you know, connected me to all of my friends via Facebook. Facebook also, I have two Facebook pages, one for The Actor's Diet, where I show recipes and food news, and then blog posts, but also my acting Facebook page, Lynn Chen. So I love my Instagram, I love my Facebook pages, I love the social media aspect of my life nowadays. It's a lot of fun to be able to share with people, because in 2005, when I had done that movie, I was getting fan letters, and that was lovely, but there wasn't really a chance for me to see back into other people's lives. So it was like people would come up to me and tell me stuff about myself, which was cool. But at the same time, you know, I want to interact with people. I want to know what's going on with you. So especially meeting other food bloggers, that's a lot of fun for me, because it's like almost like a reality show where we've been following each other, and then when you meet each other, it's like you already know each other.
Right. What are you on the most? Facebook, Twitter?
I'd say Twitter and Instagram just because they're on my phone. Mm-hmm. And they, so I can always follow a feed and have conversations with people. It's a lot of fun to interact with people on Twitter. And not everyone is on Instagram, but you know, it is a fun way to just look at people's photos. And often I will be bookmarking, restaurants to try based on people I follow, seeing food that they've eaten. And if I see, like, it's funny how trends start, you know, sometimes I'll see like a place that, you know, four different food bloggers have gone to in the last week. So I'm like, I obviously have to go there also.
What is it that you put on your YouTube channel? You don't do food cooking videos, right?
Sometimes I do. I mean, it really is everything. It's everything from, as you can see when you scroll down right now, it's my reel for acting. And then there's been performances that I've done. Like I went on tour in Germany and the Czech Republic with a punk band. So it's some of that. Sometimes I vlog. So sometimes I put those videos up. And then sometimes when I do a whole, like, when I go and do like a film festival or something, it's like a whole weekend and I'm too busy to be blogging. So I'll make a video instead of the entire week. There's just so much to see and so many exciting events that I get to attend. So I just whip out my camera and I edit a video, and it's a fun way to remember that trip. And so then I'll share that. I mean, I've been doing that since I can remember, you know, even before YouTube existed. I'd go on a trip and I'd make videos and then I'd share them with my family and friends.
Excellent.
So this is a larger way of being able to do that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, especially when I'm working on a movie, sometimes it's fun to like get a behind the scenes look with other actors and get to interview them. So it's really a mishmash of everything with the occasional food post. But no, there's not too much food stuff on that.
But still gives a wonderful insight to you and what you do and what you enjoy. And I think that's a great share.
Yeah.
So you're extremely popular on all these mediums that we looked at, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. And that's got to make you feel really, really good about what you've accomplished in the last 4 years as a food blogger, and we haven't even touched on your actress sites and such, and I imagine those are every bit as popular.
I love being able to connect with people. It's really something that is very special, and it allows you to, these social media sites allow you to do it in a way that, you know, you can share what you want to, but if you don't want to get too personal, you don't have to either. It's quite lovely.
What do you have coming up in the near future, whether it's with your food blog or your acting career?
Blog will continue going on. I feel like it's as much a part of my life as brushing my teeth is. You know, it's a habit at this point. And I, no matter how busy I get, I'm always blogging. I mean, my father passed away in August and I continued to blog every single day. And, you know, I couldn't believe I was doing it, but it's never a difficult thing for me to do. So it's going to keep going. It will always be a part of my life to some degree, I think. So blogging will keep going on. I have a lot of film festivals coming up, also a lot of travels. And I don't know. I mean, this is pilot season, as I said. So who knows? Maybe, hopefully, I'll be on a TV show very soon, but we'll see.
Well, Lynn, I wish you the best of luck in your acting career. I will be an avid follower of yours on your food blog. I think what you're doing and your advocacies that you're involved with are absolutely fantastic.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Absolutely. Lynn, thank you very much for being a guest on the Food Blog Radio Show.
This was fun.
Thanks.